first week of a very important day, the days of the Shovavim. The days of the Shovavim, every few years that we get a leap year, we get extra days of the Shovavim. And according to some Mekubalim, this is the real way to make Shovavim. Shovavim Tat. It's going to be extra 2 weeks that we're going to have the days of the Shovavim. Those days, Rabotai, it's a gift that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave to Am Yisrael, that they're able to correct the mistake of their desires. The desires that a person used to do, Hashem Erachem, Zera Levatala, different type of things that a person used to do, immorality. Those are the days, Rabotai, that Hashem gives us extra help to fix this specific thing. Says Rabbi Nachman Mibreslev, there are three big desires in this world. Which one is the, which the desires are? What desires, he says? He says the first one is the desire of eating, of food. He says there is a ta'avat achila, ta'ava of eating. The second desire is ta'avat nashim, ta'ava of women. The third desire, he says, is the ta'ava, is the desire over money, ta'avat mamon. Says Rabbi Nachman, he had to work on himself, and every one of us have to work on ourselves to correct those ta'avot, not to be attached to this, not to have the desire for this, not for food, not for women, and not for money. It says, out of those three, which one you think is the hardest one to break?
Food.
So whoever knows how to cook says food. Whoever knows how to says women. So listen, Rabotai, Rabbi Nachman Weibrestler answers. It says, for me, the easiest one was food. Second one, he said, on the list was women. It says, ta'ava of women for me was not so hard. But it says, the hardest ta'ava, the biggest desire that I had to conquer, is ta'ava of money. Ta'ava of mamon. Ta'ava of mamon, Rabotai, a person thinks, what did I do wrong? When you're eating, overeating, you make yourself not healthy, you make yourself throw up, you know, you understand it's not good. When a person is going left and right with women, he understands eventually it's not good. But when a person makes money, he says, what wrong did I do with this? Rabotai, the more a person is attached to the ta'ava of money, the harder it will be for him to be happy in this life. Says, how can a person break the ta'ava of money? Start with small amounts of giving tzedakah. A person that gives tzedakah, he breaks this ta'ava. He's not holding it to himself. He is letting it out, letting it out, letting it out. The more a person starts with small portions and is increasing this, the happier this person will be. How do we know that? It says in the last parasha, we just read about the blessings that Yaakov Avinu gave to all of his 12 children. Which blessing did he give to a person? Which child received the blessing of making money? Who remembers? Zebulun. Semach Zebulun Betzetecha Ve'isachar Ve'ohalecha. Be happy, Zebulun, that you are going and making money. Because Issachar, your brother, going to be supported by you, you're going to support him Torah. Says Rav Nachman, why the Torah said that when Yaakov gave a blessing to Zebulun to make money, he told him, be happy making the money. Semach. Sameach. Chota Sameach. Semach. Be happy making the money. He says, without your blessing, I'll be happy making money. It says you should know, the more a person is attached to money, the less happy he will be. Because there's only one time a person could be happy making money, when he makes the money in order to help others with that. It says here, Yaakov Avinu, put it in the system, in the Torah, that there's only one time a person could be sameach making money. When is that? Semach zevulun betzetecha, because Issachar, that he studies Torah, supported by you, Issachar be'ohalecha. You making money in order to give tzedakah to others with this money is going to bring you a lot of happiness. Therefore, Rabotai, a person comes up to the Sefer Torah, person takes out Sefer Torah, Ptichat Ha'echal, Hakba, all these things. This is not a joke that whenever we announce Rabotai, make sure you give tzedakah. There is kolelim to support, there is yeshivot to support, there is poor people to support. Rabotai, all this, it's opportunities that we have around throughout those weeks in this world that making our money to bring our happiness to our life. I'm able to give, I'm able to be from the sides that givers and not chas v'shalom from the sides of the receivers. Therefore, Rabotai, anytime that you are doing a mitzvah, anytime you have an opportunity to give tzedakah, don't say, I shor aset et prishol, I shor aset aliyat ha'torah nada zaplatzitz, I shor aset aliyat ha'torah nada zaplatzitz. Rabotai, this is a golden opportunity to every one of us to work on breaking the desire on the hardest level. What's the hardest level, he said, Rav Nachman? The desire of Ta'ava of Mammon. We're giving tzedakah, we're breaking this desire. Hashem, Rezat Hashem should help us. So those weeks, Shovavim, we're going to make the right tikkun. Break those desires, and Rezat Hashem, see the days of Mashiach, Tzidkenu, Amen, Amen, Amen.